Hello everyone, my name is Anil Sharma, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Arya College of Engineering and Research Center. Today we will discuss about the major component of a hydropower plant. As we all know, hydropower plant is a structure which is used to generate the electricity with the help of water, where the water is conveyed from high head to the low head with the help of conduit, and turbine is rotated, which is coupled with a shaft and generator with the generator. So in today's session, we will discuss about the major component of hydroelectric power plant. Following the, are the major component: four-way intake structure, fan stroke, surge chamber, hydraulic turbine, powerhouse, draft tube, and tail race. So these are the major component of a hydro power plant, which is generally used for the generation of electricity. Now we will discuss one by one to each component. This is the layout of a hydroelectric power plant, where all the component is shown: reservoir, surge tank, pan stroke, wall house, powerhouse, tail race. So these are the component which is shown in the layout of a hydroelectric power plant. 4B. 4B is basically a reservoir or a storage basin which is used to store the water for the temporary basin. And the storage of reservoir will depend on the water requirement, or we can say water requirement in that particular area, or the electricity demand. So the amount of water storage will depend on the electricity demand. So 4-bay, as we all know, reservoir is also a type of 4-bay, where the water is stored and a dam is constructed across a river to store the water. So 4-bay is a reservoir basin or storage basin, which is generally used to store the water, which is used for the generation of electricity, or we can say to rotate the turbine. Now the next part is the intake structure. Intake structure is a structure whose function is basically to regulate or to control the flow of water. The flow of water is regulated with the help of control valves, or we can say regulatory works is done with the help of intake structure. In the intake structure, thrust rack. Thrust rack also play an important role, because it prevents the entry of debris into the penstock, or entry of the debris or silt which is strike onto the turbine. So thrust rack is also an important part of a intake structure, which is used to control the or prevent the entry of debris into the penstock. Now next one is the penstock. Penstocks are the larger pipes which are made up of steel and concrete, and which is used to convey or which is used to transfer the water from the 4-bay structure to the turbine. So water is conveyed, penstocks which carries the water from intake structure or reservoir to the turbine. As we all know, due to the some water flow in the turbine, because these are the penstocks are fixed on some slope, so the water, the pressure water will be high. So if the water is the gates of turbine is suddenly closed, so there will be high pressure in the water which is flowing into the penstock. So there may be condition, there may be water hammer condition. So to prevent this, we have to construct the surge tank. So, and the next one is that steel and reinforced concrete is generally used for the manufacturing or for making of the penstock. So this is the image of penstock. You can see these are the larger diameter of cylindrical pipe of larger diameter, generally which convey the water from 4-bay structure to the turbine. Next is the surge chamber. As we have discussed in the previous portion, that if there is a sudden reduce, there is a sudden decrease in the electricity department, electricity demand. So we have to close the turbine gate, control gate immediately. So there will be a backflow of water in the penstock, and the water hammer condition may arise. And it may burst the penstock. To resolve this problem, we have to construct the surge tank. Surge chamber is basically surge tank or surge chamber is basically cylindrical tank which is constructed in between the penstock and which is open at the top to control the pressure, to control the pressure of water which is generated due to the water hammer. So there will be no problem if the gate of the turbine is suddenly closed. There will be no problem with the backflow of water, as the water will increase into the surge chamber. So whenever the powerhouse rejected the water load coming from the penstock, the water level in surge tank rises, which control the pressure in the penstock. So there will be no burst of the penstock if we have provided the appropriate size surge chamber in the penstock. This is the image of surge chamber which is constructed in between the penstock, where the water level is rises if there is sudden closing of control gate or control valve in the turbine. Next, hydraulic turbine. Hydraulic turbine is one of the most important part of a hydroelectric power plant, which is coupled. Hydraulic turbine is coupled with a generator. As we all know that the water storage in the reservoir have the potential energy, and this potential energy is converted into the kinematic energy when the water is come out from the penstock with the help of a nozzle or a jet spray. When the water strike on the turbine from the nozzle, then all the kinematic energy is converted into the mechanical energy. The turbine is rotated, and this mechanical energy rotate the generator, which produce the electric energy. So hydraulic turbine is a device which can convert the hydraulic energy into the mechanical energy, which is again converted into the electric energy by coupling the shaft of turbine to the generator. So this turbine is generally coupled with a generator, where the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy. Now there are two main type of the hydraulic turbine which is used for the electricity generation: impulse turbine and reaction turbine. Impulse turbine are the turbines where the nozzle is, water is directly strike to the buckets or to the bucket of the turbine. But in the case of reaction turbine, reaction turbine works on the principle of Newton's third law, where there will be if there is action is performed, then there will be equal and same amount of reaction force will be applied. So an impulse turbine is basically works on the principle of Newton's second law of motion. So there are two types of turbine which is used for the generation of electricity. This is the image of this is a penstock where water is strike to the turbine. These are the buckets of turbine where when the high pressure water with a high velocity is strike on this bucket, then it rotate into the anticlockwise direction. This is the runner portion which rotate in the anticlockwise direction. So this is the example of the impulse turbine where the water is strike with a nozzle spray or with the help of needle valve. The water is having a high pressure, high kinematic velocity, which is converted into the mechanical energy, as we have already discussed. Now the next one is the powerhouse structure. Powerhouse structure is basically a building which is generally provided to protect the hydraulic and electric. Basically, it is a structure which is constructed to protect the hydraulic and electric equipment like generator or hydraulic equipment. We can say these large size turbines. So these are the protected with a covering structure which is known as the powerhouse. There are some if we are going to sometime foundation is also provided to support the heavy equipment or large equipments. So this is all about the powerhouse. Now the next is the draft tube. As we all know, if you are using the impulse turbine, then there is no need to provide the draft tube. As we all know, draft tube is a device which is having the enlarged diameter from low diameter to the high diameter, or we can say large diameter. So if you if you are using the reaction turbine, then the draft tube is a necessary component which connect the turbine outlet to the tail race. When the water come out from the turbine, it is diverted to the tail race with the help of draft tube. Draft tube is basically generally used to increase the pressure, or we can say ki, make the atmospheric pressure, the where the water in the tail race is in atmospheric pressure, so to decrease or to increase the water pressure, or we can say the pressure. So draft tube is used and it is provided with the increasing diameter, as we will see in the diagram. This is the draft, this is the turbine, we can say penstock. Water is strike to the penstock and it is then diverted with the help of draft tube into the tail race. So draft tube is a device of enlarging diameter, having the diameter outlet at a large diameter, where the water pressure is increased up to the atmospheric pressure. So there will be no problem in the when the water is immersed to the tail race. Now tail race. Tail race is basically, we can send a downstream portion of a hydroelectric power plant, where the water is, where tail race is the flow of water from turbine to the stream, and where the water is from, which has come out from the turbine, is submerged into the tail race, from where it is again can be mixed into the original water stream, or it may be diverted into the another water stream. So, but if it is located far away from the stream, then it is necessary to build a channel. If it is, it have to be merged into the another channel, then there will be we have to provide a channel for carrying the water into the stream. So this is all about the major component of a hydroelectric power plant. I hope you will all understand. Thank you so much. Thank you.